Hi, the Bill Muller coil design has been a kind of a mystery to me and many, many other people, and for a long time I didn't grasp what he was trying to do. But what he's trying to come up with is a way of winding a coil using the least amount of wire to get the most current out. So this is why it looks like a pyramid. It's all based on the loss factor of the square of the distance. So if you wind a coil going outward radially, the output of the core diminishes by the square of the distance. So it eventually just peters off and gets weaker and weaker. This is also true as you go down the core, the length of the core. And so if you look what he's done here, the first winding, he has wound, he's got, let's see here, 14 turns along the core length. And he's got a little bit of the core sticking out the back and also out of the front. This has to be played with to figure out what's the best. And then the next thing he wants to do is he needs to have more turns to get the voltage he needs as well as current. So he's going to wind a two-layer coil on top of the first one, but he starts a third in from the front to the end. Okay, so now those are twice as many turns because it's weaker at that point. And then he proceeds to go on to the third winding, which is based on the same idea that it's now diminished even further, so you need to have more turns. So no, you couldn't just make this all one big blob on the front end because you would not get the current needed. You'd get the voltage, but you wouldn't get the current needed. So this is a very interesting way of doing things. And he's using the magnetite core, which we have made. We had found, as far as ferrite cores out there, we had bought some Soviet surplus that had a permeability of 800. And as far as the permeability goes, it is way superior than the magnetite core. But the magnetite has its own advantages. And so, but if you're going to pour your core, you need to make sure it is magnetically aligned. You got to do that. And so I'll leave it up to you to figure out how to do that, but it's not a hard thing. The key in this Muller thing is to really look at the problems first that need to be overcome and do that before you start anything else. And it may take you longer, but in the long run, you're going to save a lot of time. And that's really important. So let's kind of just review everything. We want to use the minimum amount of wire. You can use a bifiler. We're using a quinfiler on ours. And it can be Litz wire or not. It doesn't matter in this application. The frequencies are not high enough that you're going to pick up any beneficial current. But if you want to go that way, feel free to do. There's nothing wrong with that. Then, you know, you're going to have to work on this anti-cogging problem. We have it 100% solved. But every time you have the anti-cogging, you're going to require more power to run the motor. Thus, are you going to ever get back to over unity? And what we're building here is on a much larger scale. It's on the scale of Bill Muller's unit as far as physical size, but simplicity. And when it runs, it's absolutely quiet and no cogging. Thank you very much for watching.